Teachers, colleague debaters, students, good morning to you all. I am here before you strongly supporting the given topic, which says military is superior to civilian known as a system of government in Nigeria. But before going further, some definitions first. Military in Nigeria is generally any government that administrated by military forces. Civilian region, in other hand, is generally the government ruled by some citizens that are not members of armed forces. Based on Nigerian context, leaders under military region are always coming to power through coup d'etats. There is no doubt about it. But the realism behind their coming into power was to save the country from destruction. Civilian leaders in Nigeria are those that always deceive their masses and fool them. They always pretend to be the lover of this nation and that they will do everything within their power to develop our standard of living. In Nigerian context, leader under military region is far better than the civilian counterpart, because under military there is discipline everywhere in the country. Every single individual is afraid of violating law, for he knows the consequences that might be called upon him. Civil servants are alive to their responsibilities because they know that the government is not tolerating any nonsense. Civil servants are alive to their responsibilities, coming to work in time and staying till the closing hour. Police officers are not collecting bribe from anybody. A local hawker that is selling sugar cane will wait for you to finish so he can pack the waste and dump it in dustbin. But in civilian region, there is no discipline at all. People are not afraid of violating law because they know that the government is weak. The leaders are very good and clever in looting the national treasury. Civil servants are not alive to their responsibilities because they knew that nothing can be done to them. Irregularities are everywhere. The system is completely dirty. Some uneducated area boys are better in the eyes of civilian leaders than school teachers. A good example is what happened in Hapsato Ahmadu Bello's country here in Sokoto. A serving state commissioner sent area boys to go and mercilessly beat the school teacher just because he punished one of the students. Take a look at this nonsense. Do you think something like this can happen in military region? The answer is no. It was due to the weakness of the civilian regime that the problem of armed robbery became rampant in Nigeria. Take a look at what is currently happening in Zamfara, Gundumi, Kaduna, Lagos, and others. Kidnapping became rampant in Zamfara, Kaduna, Sokoto, and others. Thousand people lost their lives due to religious clashes that are frequently happening in Zamfara, Kaduna, Jos, and other places. All these are happening under the current civilian regime, and that and my brothers are here. Shamelessly saying civilian regime is superior to military regime. Mr. Chairman, sir, before I go back and take my seat, I have to give you some examples that will help you understand that there is total disrespect of law and order in civilian regime. The life of Senate President Mukola Saraiki, Baba Trila, Osambo Dasuki, and others. All the mentioned individuals are top government officials, and as a result of that, nothing can be done to them. Imagine if something like this happened in military region. I believe death sentence is the least they can get. Mr. Chairman, sir, with the above given clear examples, I believe you and my listeners are now convinced that in Nigerian context, military region is far superior, better in quality, advanced in development, enhancing economy, better in taking action, finer in imitating than civilian region, which is imperial, lower, lesser, poorer, substandard, low grade, or second rate in anything. Thank you for listening. May God save this country, Nigeria, from this uneducated civilian.